Welcome, everyone, to the Fall 2017 College of Education Convocation. My name is Craig Kennedy. I'm Dean of the College of Education, and I welcome all of you. The college was founded in 1908 to bring teacher education to the state of Georgia. Since then, we have flourished, grown, and matured as a college. We currently have over 4,200 students and annually graduate 1,100 individuals who go on to careers in education, mental and physical health, and human development. Our college has over 7 programs that are in the top 10 of their respective fields. In these rankings, our college is equivalent to Ohio State, the University of Wisconsin, and Pennsylvania State University. Our faculty bring in over $15 million a year annually in research support, and the college contributes more than $85 million each year to Georgia's economy. I would like to begin today's convocation with an introduction of our platform party. I would ask that each individual rise when I introduce her to receive our appreciation and applause. First is Dr. Denise Spangler. Dr. Spangler is Senior Associate Dean of the College of Education and the B.B. Atterhold Professor of Early Childhood Education. Dr. Spangler will introduce our convocation speaker. Next, our convocation speaker is Kristy Kowal. Ms. Kowal is a member of the United States swimming team, Olympic medalist, and is an alumna of the College of Education. We are very pleased that Ms. Kowal could serve as our convocation speaker today. Finally, we have Dr. Anne Marcotte. Dr. Marcotte is professor of communication sciences and special education and department head of language and literacy education. Dr. Marcotte will read the names of our graduates. Now, let me turn to my remarks. As Dean of the College of Education, it is my distinct pleasure to preside over today's convocation ceremony. It is a celebration of how a university education can transform people's lives. Graduates, please stand. Today is your day, and we applaud all of you, class of 2017. Graduates, your accomplishments we are celebrating today have been assisted by many people in your lives. Your parents, grandparents, siblings, partners, friends, and others. Please give them a round of applause. There are 220 faculty members in the 9 departments of the college who have taught and mentored you. Everyone, please join me in thanking our faculty. Finally, we have many wonderful staff members in the College of Education. These individuals, often without your knowing, have been instrumental in helping you earn your degree. I ask all of us to thank the staff in the departments, student services, information technology, library, and many others. Thank you. Graduates, this is a day of celebration for your passion for learning and for helping others. Convocation is a time-honored ritual that marks all that you have accomplished thus far in your lives. Please make sure and enjoy this moment. It occurs once in a lifetime. And now, it is my honor to introduce Dr. Denise Spangler, Senior Associate Dean in the College of Education and the B.B. Atterhold Professor in Early Childhood Education. She earned her doctorate in mathematics here at University of Georgia. After completing her degree, she joined the faculty in the Department of Mathematics and Science Education in the college, where she rose through the ranks to become a full professor, an endowed chair, and department head. She is a nationally and internationally known scholar for her work in pre-service mathematics teacher education. Dr. Spangler, please come to the podium to introduce our convocation speaker.
Thank you, Dean Kennedy. It's my pleasure to introduce today's convocation speaker, Kristy Kowal, a 2002 graduate of the College of Education with a degree in early childhood education. She also holds a master's degree from Gratz College. Kristy is a shining example of excellence, integrity, and service to others above self. During her time at UGA, Kristy excelled academically, athletically, and in community service, and she has given much back to the University of Georgia and the community at large since graduation. Kristy's athletic accolades and accomplishments are too numerous to mention them all, but I will give you a small taste of her many achievements. First, Dean Kennedy already mentioned, Kristy won the silver medal in the 200-meter breaststroke at the 2000 Olympic Games in Sydney, Australia. As a member of the University of Georgia women's swimming team, she was a 22-time All-American and won 8 NCAA championships, the most national titles won by any student athlete in any sport in UGA history. She holds 6 UGA records, was the most valuable player of the swimming team all 4 years she was at UGA, and was a member of 2 NCAA championship teams. In 2000, she was named the NCAA Woman of the Year, an honor accorded to only 1 female college athlete each year on the basis of academic and athletic excellence, as well as community service. On the national and international swimming scene, she set 1 world record and 8 American records, and was the first woman in the world to break the 1-minute mark in the 100-yard breaststroke. Academically, Kristy excelled as an early childhood education major. I can personally attest to her passion and dedication to her major, as I had the privilege of having her in class. Kristy was enthusiastic and highly engaged as a student, and watching her with children was pure magic. She has a way of connecting with students on a personal level that motivates them to work hard. In addition to engaging students, she is also exceptionally talented at helping students learn difficult content by making connections to the real world and to other content they already know. She is currently in her 13th year of teaching third grade in Pennsylvania, where she is involved in a variety of school and district-based activities and committees. A final arena in which Kristy has done remarkable things is community service. As a student, Kristy was heavily engaged in the community, and she has continued to use her passion for swimming to serve the community. In particular, she's a regular participant in Swim Across America, a charity that hosts swimming events in places such as Boston Harbor and the San Francisco Bay, where amateur swimmers and Olympians swim together to raise money to fund cancer research and clinical trials for pediatric cancer. As part of each event, the swimmers visit cancer patients in local hospitals. So far, Swim Across America has raised $70 million. In addition to devoting her personal time to charity events, Kristy also teaches her students the value of community service, compassion for others, and gratitude. As a few examples, her students have been involved in service events such as buying a 5-year-old a hand crank bicycle, providing malaria vaccines for an entire village of mothers and children, and writing thank you notes to soldiers and veterans during the holidays through Operation Gratitude. As should be obvious by now, we are incredibly proud to call Kristy Kowal an alumna of the University of Georgia College of Education. She is using her degree and her athletic prowess to change lives in significant ways. I know you will be inspired by her remarks, and I hope you will carry that inspiration with you into your careers and personal lives and make just 1/10 the difference that Kristy has made. Kristy Kowal, your convocation speaker.
Thank you so much. That is the kindest introduction I have ever received. Thank you, Dean Kennedy, and thank you, Dr. Spangler, for having me here today. How long is 1/100th of a second? Is it a blink of an eye? Is it the amount of time it takes for lightning to strike? Is it enough time for a hummingbird to flap its wings? Sometimes that fraction of a second can be the difference between your dream coming true or the biggest disappointment in your life. For as long as I can remember, my life has been measured by these fractions of a second. I knew I wanted to be an Olympian from the time I was 8 years old. Now, Olympians are exceptional athletes in their sport. What I need you to understand is exceptional is not a word I would use to describe myself as an 8-year-old. You see, I started swimming because my mom wanted me to be water safe, and she wasn't the best swimmer in the world, but we were going to be spending our summers at the pool. So I loved swimming from the moment I jumped in the water. I absolutely adored it, but I need you to picture it. A skinny, shivering little girl standing on the blocks in lane one, no cap, no goggles. I was in lane one because I couldn't make it all the way to the other end of the pool without stopping. 5 times, 6 times, 7 times, 10 times probably. And every time I stopped, there were my coaches yelling at me to keep going. And when I got to the other end, I was greeted with a participation ribbon. So you can imagine my parents' surprise when I saw swimming on the TV during the Olympics, and I told them that I wanted to do that, that one day I too would be among the greatest swimmers in the world, wearing an American flag cap on my head. After their initial shock and their answer of, you know, you have to be really good to go to the Olympics, right? I told them, I know. I also told them that one day I wanted to be a teacher, which gave them a great sigh of relief as I had plan B when my Olympic plans did not pan out. For you future teachers out there, I was so not good at swimming that, in fact, there was 1 year I was placed on the C team. Now let's relate this to grades. The A team swimmers. Those were the really good swimmers. The C team swimmers? Those were the needs improvement kiddos. That was me. But still, my parents never once told me that I would most likely never stand on the podium at the Olympics. Now, over the next several years, after growing many inches and swimming the equivalent of the distance around the equator, and then just a few more miles just for fun, I was lucky enough to earn a scholarship to the University of Georgia where I could pursue both of my dreams, becoming a teacher and earning a spot on the Olympic team. Along the way to the medal podium, I've learned a lot of life-changing lessons. One of the most important lessons I've learned is to stare adversity in the face and tell it to, and to win that staring contest. See, in order to qualify for our Olympic team in swimming, you have to be one of the top 2 swimmers in the country on that day. I tried to qualify for my first Olympic team when I was 17 years old. I was a senior in high school. The Olympic trials is a terrifying place. It's the most stressful swim meet a swimmer can go to, and I was only 17 years old. I don't remember much about my race except for standing behind the blocks thinking, just get first or second, just get first or second. I swam as fast as I could. I touched the wall. I counted to 5. I turned around, and I saw a 3rd place behind my name. I had just missed the Olympic team by 17 one-hundredths of a second. So I did what any 17-year-old did. I got out of the water, and I went over and sat at the diving well, crying, looked up at the stands, saw my parents screaming, "We love you!" Where I was like, "Yeah, great." Little did I know there was a photographer taking my picture of me crying, sitting at the diving well. And a month later, my picture would grace the cover of Swimming World magazine. They had a split cover. The girl who had beat me was smiling and waving, and I was sitting and crying. They called it the agony and the ecstasy. I was the agony. This was a defining moment in my life. You see, people talk about waiting for moments to define them, but in reality, they are happening to you all of the time. I had to ask myself, was I going to let this moment define me? Would I walk away from swimming, Or was I going to be super stubborn, I'm Italian by the way, and be that girl who never gets third place again? Well, I had to wait 4 more years to find out. Four years later, with a world record, a few American records, and a world championship title under my belt, I decided that this was my time to be an Olympian. And for those people who say that lightning doesn't strike twice in the same place, well, they're liars. Because this time, in my very first event, I missed the Olympic team by 1/100th of a second, which is the smallest fraction of time you can actually miss the Olympic team by, and it takes talent to do this. But it was okay. I had been here before. I knew what to do. I had to get myself out of the pool before anybody could take a picture of me crying. But really, I knew what to do. I dusted myself off, and 2 days later, I made the Olympic team in the 200 breaststroke and went on to win the silver medal in the games. In this life that is waiting for you after graduation, you are going to encounter obstacles. You may be one person out of 400 people interviewing for a job. You may need to interview 20 times for that same job. You may be told no more than yes. You are entering highly competitive fields. You will face adversity, and you will have to ask yourself again and again, how am I going to let this moment define me? Every challenge you face is going to make you stronger, and it's going to help you gain experience. There are going to be days where you win, and those days are my favorite. But on the days when you fall down, those are the days where you're going to learn the most about yourself. Every day you will face obstacles, and every day you are going to overcome them, and do not give up until you do. Another thing that I have learned along the way is that no one can make it alone. I have always said that you are only as good as the people that you surround yourself with. Obviously, this is why I ended up at Georgia. So I make sure that I surround myself with some pretty amazing and intelligent people, because I've learned over the years to ask for help when I need it. You are going to find yourself in situations that you have no idea what is going on, and you might not even know where to go for help. And you definitely don't want to be the person who doesn't ask for help, or you don't want to know, or you don't want to look like you don't know what is going on, so you don't ask for help. Believe me, I've been there. My first year of teaching, I shared an adjoining door to a room with my mentor teacher. And the first thing I did every single morning was prop that door right open. It saved my life. I got over very quickly the embarrassment of not knowing the answers to everything. I've even been known to tell my students, that's a great question. Let's Google it. Knowing when to ask for help is a sign of strength, not weakness. I would like to share a final point, best summed up with a quote by Benjamin Franklin. As part of his daily schedule, at the start and end of his day, he would ask himself, "What good shall I do today? And what good have I done today?" Your legacy is what you are writing every day through the people whose lives you have an impact on. Every single moment, you are building your legacy. Your professions are part of your legacy, so build it with purpose and with passion. You will make a change, and you will make a difference in people's lives just by simply doing the jobs that you have chosen to do. You will be teachers, occupational therapists, physician's assistants, physical therapists, sports trainers, speech pathologists, counselors, and so much more. In our professions, we have a unique opportunity to impact people in a life-changing way that will leave a footprint on their lives. The impact that we have on the people we help, that right there, that's worthy of an Olympic medal. David Brooks in a New York Times column suggests that high-performing individuals begin with two beliefs. One, the future can be better than the present, and two, I have the power to make it so. So as you're standing on the starting blocks of your life, where even a hundredth of a second can make all the difference in the world, I ask you this in parting. How are you going to make the most of it? Congratulations, class of 2017.
Thank you, Kristy. That was absolutely fabulous. And now, we have the privilege of recognizing those of you who will receive your degrees this semester from the College of Education. Some of you have earned bachelor's degrees, some have earned master's degrees, and some have earned specialist degrees. Many of you have qualified for initial teacher certification, qualified to apply for licensure in professional areas, or added another area of specialization to your professional credentials. Many of you have completed original research in an undergraduate project, an honors project, or a master's thesis. Many of you have provided important service to the community through your service learning activities, and many of you have accomplished all of this while maintaining grade point averages high enough that you are graduating cum laude, magna cum laude, or summa cum laude. Some of you did this while working, while taking care of your children or your parents, or while blazing your own trail as the first person in your family to attend college. All of you have worked very, very hard, and that is why we call it earning a degree. We are all very proud of you, and we are pleased to be able to recognize your work and your accomplishments here this afternoon. Now, we will begin the convocation procession. The graduates will approach the stage from the audience's right and be introduced by department. Now, normally at this point in time, I make a statement about holding your applause until the end of the event and all individuals have shaken hands. But I've been doing this long enough that I know that's just something that doesn't happen. So I would appreciate it, and your loved one would appreciate it, if you make all the noise you want as that individual walks across the stage. All right. Very, very good. Now, introducing our graduates today is Dr. Anne Marcotte, Professor of Communication Sciences and Special Education and Department Head of Language and Literacy Education. Dr. Marcotte, please come to the podium.
We begin our recognition of graduates with the Department of Career and Information Studies, which includes programs in learning, design, and technology, and in workforce education. This department prepares undergraduates to become career and technical education teachers, while those completing graduate degrees typically assume leadership positions within the instructional technology units of school systems, governments, businesses, or industry. Career and Information Studies alumni also produce research and invent information systems with emphases on creativity and innovation for today's careers and for careers of the future. The Department of Career and Information Studies is represented this afternoon by one graduate who has earned the degree Master of Education in Learning, Design, and Technology. Elizabeth Lynn White. Our next graduates have earned degrees from the Department of Communication Sciences and Special Education, which focuses on the needs of persons who can benefit from a range of approaches to teaching, learning, or communication. Whether they are continuing on to serve as early childhood special educators, to work as special education teachers, to complete graduate studies, or to work in speech-language pathology or audiology, or to contribute to their world in other ways, all of these graduates carry with them the department's mission of helping all persons become as independent as they can possibly become. The Department of Communication Sciences and Special Education is proud to present graduates from two degree programs. First, we recognize those who have earned the degree Master of Arts for Teachers in Special Education. Tiffany Sierra Warren. Rebecca Elizabeth Rogers. We are also pleased to recognize one graduate who has earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in Special Education, Brenda Lee. Our next graduates have all earned degrees from the Department of Educational Theory and Practice, which includes programs in early childhood education, middle grades education, and social studies education. This department prepares students for careers as educators and researchers who focus on children and adolescents, their families, and their communities. The programs in this department routinely rank among the top 10 in the nation, according to U.S. News and World Report, and all of their graduates share the department's commitment to fostering equity and social justice in education around the globe. The Department of Educational Theory and Practice is proud to present several graduates this afternoon, beginning with those who have earned master's degrees. These include the Master of Arts for Teachers, or the Master of Education, some with expertise in early childhood education, and some with expertise in social studies education. Beginning with Heather Nicole Phillips. Elizabeth Rose Hicks. Amy Michelle Stevick. And Crystal Gail Polk. The Department of Educational Theory and Practice is also honored to present a large group of graduates this afternoon who have all earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in Early Childhood Education. Samantha Irene Naparella. Taylor Nicole Bussey. Cassidy Christine Butler. Sarah Rose Erdman. Geneva Louise Hinkle. Colleen Rebecca Gronick. Paige Christine Caffrey. Jessica Carol Thompson. Michelle Kelly Leggett. Brooke Ching Ching Gable. Ashley Sarah Fagler. Ashley Ann Shepherd. Haley Morgan Sinereski. Tara Leanne Poston. Danica Rose Whedon. Chelsea Kuhn. Kaylin Rose McKenzie. Hannah Elizabeth Martin. Emma Grace Burge. Ashley Ann Barr. Amy Patricia Flanagan. Mary Patrick Gilly. Rachel Elaine Carter. Amanda Mailer Hawks. Julia Hebin Park. Kendall Jackson. Falia Olaide Ibidapo. Yemenyushal Solomon. Emily Morgan Dewey. Carrie Alice Kendrick Holmes. The next graduates have earned degrees from the Department of Kinesiology. The mission of this department is to enhance health and well-being for people throughout the lifespan through the creation, transmission, and application of knowledge related to physical activity, exercise, and sport. The department's bachelor's and master's programs prepare students for careers as practitioners in allied health fields, in teaching and coaching, and in sport enterprises, and for careers as scholars and researchers in higher education, government, and industry. The Department of Kinesiology is pleased to present several graduates this afternoon, beginning with those who have earned the degree Master of Science in Sport Management or in Kinesiology. William Stephen Colquitt. Jonna Gabrielle Burchett. Sehwan Kim. The Department of Kinesiology is also very proud of its many graduates who have earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education, with majors this semester in Exercise and Sport Science, Health and Physical Education, or Sport Management, or for some of them the double major, Athletic Training and Exercise and Sport Science. Nicholas Joseph Fonseca. Zachary Porter Carlton. Jordan Mark Anthony Davis. Kevin Fidel Telford. Tyler Clark Wright. Joshua Paul McMillan. Daniel Robert Cochran. Taylor Davis Martin. Austin Richard Schulte. Kayla Sierra White. Marin Grace Landrum. Samantha Grace Miller. Aaliyah Nicole Vick. Bridget Alexandria Ochuco. Lindsay Paige Rainey. Forrest Collins Russell. Ansley Catherine Austin. Mallory Leanne Boswell. Travis Eric Huttner. Rosetta Shibu Kozikatu. Bethany Hollins Nelson. Grace Catherine Hodges. Shelby Ledford Dobbs. Ashley Nicole Hendrick. Taylor Guadalupe Knittle. And Ashley Michelle Waite. We now turn to the Department of Language and Literacy Education, which offers degrees and other programs in English education, reading literacies and children's literature, teaching English for speakers of other languages, and world language education. Through multimedia efforts in reading, composition, interpretation, and all other aspects of language use, the professionals in language and literacy education seek to provide learners and communities the tools they need to produce, access, and learn from all forms of languages and media at home, at school, and around the world. The Department of Language and Literacy Education is honored to present several graduates this afternoon who have earned the degree Master of Arts for Teachers, all with expertise in English education. Shannon Marie McRae and Christopher Andrew White. We next recognize the Department of Lifelong Education, Administration, and Policy, which includes programs in educational administration and policy, learning, leadership, and organization development, and qualitative research. The overriding mission of this department is to train professionals who will administer and improve the educational programs of Georgia, the Southeast, and the nation based on rigorous evaluative techniques, whether those programs are focused on education for students in kindergarten through the 12th grade or designed to provide education for adults. The Department of Lifelong Education, Administration, and Policy is represented this afternoon by one graduate who has earned the degree Master of Education in Educational Administration and Policy. Terry Lynn Schneider. That brings us to our final department for this afternoon, the Department of Mathematics and Science Education. Graduates from mathematics and science education are equipped with the knowledge and skills necessary to be leaders in the arenas of instruction, curriculum, assessment, and policy for mathematics and the sciences, and for learners in preschool through college settings. Given the importance of mathematics and science literacy in our society today, the faculty in mathematics and science education are very proud of the contributions the department's alumni make through their teaching, research, and service in mathematics and the sciences. We are therefore very pleased to recognize our final group of graduates for fall semester 2017, those who have earned the degree Bachelor of Science in Education with a major in mathematics education or a major in science education. Elizabeth Ansley Pollock. Mary Claire Cashin. Elizabeth Ann Mundell. Cameron Scott Adkins. And Diem Nock Nguyen. Dean Kennedy, the graduates of the College of Education for fall 2017.
Thank you, Dr. Marcotte, members of the platform party. It is now my great pleasure to introduce our final speaker for the 2017 College of Education Convocation. Our student convocation speaker is Samantha Naparella. Sammy is from Lawrenceville, Georgia. After transferring to the University of Georgia in fall 2015, Sammy became an active member of the Early Childhood Education Program and the College of Education Student Ambassadors Program. This year, she served on the executive board in the role of Vice President of Operations. Sammy is graduating summa cum laude and as the college's only first honor graduate. Sammy's dedication and drive for academic excellence exemplifies the best of our college. Please help me in welcoming Sammy Naparella.
Good afternoon. Ladies and gentlemen, esteemed faculty and staff of the College of Education, proud family and friends, I'm incredibly honored and humbled to be speaking to you today. On behalf of my fellow graduates, thank you for joining us at the College of Education's Fall 2017 Convocation. If any one of you in this room had told me 3 years ago I would be on this stage, giving this speech, and graduating from this university, I can't even imagine what I would have said in reply. Let's just say that none of that was in my plans at that time. Although I was accepted to UGA as a first-time student, I began my college career at another SEC institution far from home. I, of course, went into this new phase of life thinking I had made the right choice. But to my surprise, my choice wasn't as perfect as I thought. I watched all my friends from high school finding their new place in the world, something bigger than themselves, while I felt small, overwhelmed, and lost. Even before my first semester was over, I knew I was going to transfer. The following spring, I attended a smaller, local college close to home to gather my thoughts, regroup, and decide what to do next. I was accepted to UGA as a transfer student for the next fall and moved to Athens in the fall of 2015 as an intended early childhood education major with the knowledge that UGA had one of the best early childhood programs in the nation. At this point, after transferring twice before my sophomore year began, a small part of me had started to believe that the college experience of forever friendship, that sense of pride and belonging, just wasn't in the cards for me. Fortunately, I could not have been more wrong. From enrolling in a transfer student seminar my first semester at UGA, to being accepted into a cohort of amazing future early childhood educators, to serving on the executive board for the College of Education Student Ambassador Program, the people I have met and the memories I have made, courtesy of the College of Education, are endless. While sometimes I do wonder where I might be today, if I had spent my freshman year living in Creswell Hall or having a late night meal at Snelling, I firmly believe that the course of my life was laid out in a specific way and for a specific reason. If I had chosen to settle for my college experience and education, or lowered my expectations for this important chapter of my life, I'm certain I would not be standing here in front of you today. In addition to becoming involved in student life at the College of Education, I also had the wonderful once-in-a-lifetime opportunity to study abroad in Glasgow, Scotland, for 4 weeks with 16 other UGA students this past summer. At a local university in downtown Glasgow, we studied how the history, culture, and current political atmosphere dictated Scottish schools and the way they ran in comparison to schools in the United States. We also had the opportunity to tour 3 schools in the Glasgow area and talk to their students and staff about their schools, each as unique as any school here in America. Through this experience, I not only puzzled over which direction cars might come from when crossing the road, but also gained a different and deeper perspective into my future life as an educator. Students at a high school in Glasgow were given the chance to ask their visitors any question they liked. These 15-year-olds wanted to know the current state of healthcare in America, a surprising but intriguing question that caused me to think about how little I actually knew about the subject and what might cause them to ask that question. My second grade students at Statham Elementary this semester were interested in learning more about hurricanes, how and why they form, and the aftermath and direct impact they felt of Hurricane Irma this past September. Children everywhere are inquisitive. They are naturally resilient and forgiving, despite wherever they may come from. It's their life experiences that influence how they see and understand the world around them. It is our job as graduates of the College of Education not to alter or judge those experiences, but to be their advocates, to be their voice when they cannot articulate it for themselves. While only a small portion of us in this room will be applying these lessons in a classroom, keep this in mind for whoever you will serve in your future profession. Our most simple and most essential purpose is to advocate by fostering kindness and empathy in others, who will go out into the world and be the best version of themselves, just as the University of Georgia has done for us. To the family and friends who have traveled to Athens to support us, to the faculty and staff of the College of Education who have given their career to educating us these past few years. I have the honor of saying a most sincere thank you on behalf of the graduates this fall. If it takes a village to raise a child, it takes the entire Bulldog Nation to get a UGA student to graduation. To my fellow graduates, congratulations, we did it! Hundreds of hours of practicum and internships, countless nights spent writing papers and completing projects, finally over as this hectic chapter of our lives comes to a close. Tomorrow at commencement, or more likely in the mail in a few weeks, we will receive a diploma from the University of Georgia. But this is the question I have for you. What will you do with it? At the end of the day, the diploma itself is just a piece of paper. We could have gone to any college or university in the nation and received an almost identical copy of that diploma to get us to the next step in our lives, a job, an internship, graduate school. So, fellow graduates, how will you use your degree to be the person who you want to be? How will you be sure that your clients, students, or whoever you serve feel that you are advocating for them? How will you use your experiences and education found only here at UGA to better yourself and the world around us? Whether that means doing your best to very badly explain the American healthcare system to some Scottish teenagers, or explaining to young children that using the word Irma as an insult, while resourceful, isn't very nice, these questions are things we'll have to ask ourselves throughout our professional careers, a time of lifelong learning and endless personal growth. If there is one thing I want you to get out of my speech today, it's to never settle for anything in your life. Whether or not I knew it at the time, I chose not to settle for my college education and transferred to UGA 2 years ago. So, don't settle for that graduate school, master's, or PhD program just because you got in. Don't settle for that job just because it's the first offer you get. You worked hard for this degree, and hopefully you learned a thing or two along the way. You will have the ability to change the world through the acts of advocacy, empathy, and kindness towards your clients, students, coworkers, whoever you will serve, courtesy of the degree you are about to earn. You are a graduate of the University of Georgia. Congratulations, and go Dawgs.
Thank you, Sammy. That was very impressive. Thank you again, families, faculty, and staff. Everyone has many reasons to be proud today and many reasons to celebrate. Graduates, you are now alumni of the College of Education. You are now a member of a community that includes over 60,000 living alumni. Many of these individuals have gone on to great accomplishments and made important contributions to Georgia and the nation. We expect no less of each of you. We look forward in the future to hearing with great pride about the impressive accomplishments and important contributions made by the class of 2017. Audience, it is our pleasure to present to you the class of 2017. Now, it's become a College of Education tradition at our convocation to recognize a very important event that occurs during your experience here. And so now, let me call back Sammy to return to the podium to lead our new graduates in calling the dogs.
Okay, I need everyone to stand up if you are able. Everyone stand up. Now for the fun part. It is my honor to call the 2017 SEC champion, Georgia Bulldogs. Raise your fist, please. Go Dawgs! Sick 'em!
All right, thank you, everyone. Class is dismissed.